तो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, तो वी कंप्लीटेड विद द इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट नो. सो दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट्स आर वेरी मच इम्पोर्टेंट ड्यूरिंग द प्रोग्रामिंग. सो व्हाट आई प्लान्ड, वन मोर टाइम आई वांट टू रिवाइज दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट्स. ओके, सो वी ऑलरेडी आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द स्ट्रिंग एंड ब्रांच इंस्ट्रक्शन इन द लास्ट क्लास. सो वन मोर टाइम इफ आई रिवाइज यू विल गेट वन ए क्लियर कट आइडिया. So here, if you see, I'm sharing one material. So if you see this one, so these are the classification of instruction set. Okay, is it okay, students? Is it okay, students? In this class, we will discuss these instruction set. And in the next class, we'll go for the next topic. Can anyone give a response? Students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, here if you see, this is one of the important material I will share you in the Google Classroom. Okay. So, classification of instruction sets of 8086. So, total how many? Total 10 instruction sets are there. This one is data transfer instructions. Example, move, push, pop. Okay, arithmetic instructions, add, sub, mul. Okay, logic instructions and bit manipulation instructions, AND, OR, XOR, and shift instructions and rotate instructions. These are ROL, RCL, ROR, and SHL. And program execution and transfer instruction. Those are nothing but branch instructions. Okay. So here you have jump, call, and jump with carry. Okay, so unconditional jumps and call instructions and conditional jumps. Okay, jump with carry is nothing but conditional instructions. And iteration control instructions, those are nothing but we are using in the iteration. That means if you want to execute the program like 5 times or 10 times, okay, so you have to use the loop instructions. Those are nothing but loop if zero, loop if no zero. Okay, unconditional loops and conditional loops are there. And the process control instructions, in this you have so in order to operate with the flags, these instructions will be operating on the flag. Set carry, clear carry, complement carry, these are nothing but process control instructions. And external hardware synchronization instruction, these are lock, escape, wait. Okay, and interrupt control instructions, int n, I return, int 0. So these are nothing but interrupt overflow. And the string instructions, so these already we already discussed, move SB, move string byte, load string byte, store string byte. Okay, so here if you see, first data transfer instructions. Okay, so students, can you able to see this whatever I'm explaining? Please give response so that I can move forward.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So see here, this is a data transfer instruction. Data transfer instruction is nothing but you are copying some the content of one memory location or some content of the register or a immediate value to some other destination register. Okay, so here for copying the whatever the content of source to the destination, you have an instruction called move instruction. Okay, so move is nothing but in order to copy some content of source, you are using this move instruction. This is the format for the move instruction: move destination comma source. So whatever the value present in the source, you are moving into destination. Okay, so moves a byte or word from the source. Okay, so from the source to destination. So specified instruction. Okay, so source can be a register, memory location, immediate number. Okay, it can be immediate value or a register or memory location. So destination should be a register and memory location. So these are the examples. So you have to remember this: both the source and destination cannot be a memory location. So we cannot move the data between the same means between the two different memory locations. Okay. So if you want to move the data to two memory location, first whatever the data present in the location, first you have to move into some temporary register. After moving the data again, you have to move into the address location. Okay. So these are the examples: move CX, 0037H, So 37 H is nothing but the immediate value. Okay, this is the immediate addressing mode. So whatever the immediate value is there, you are moving into CX register. And move BL comma 4000 H. So that means 4000 H is there. So there will be some value. 8 bit value is there in the 4000 H. 4000 H is nothing but the direct address. And the data is there in which segment? Data segment. Okay. So physical address is calculated like this. DS colon 40H. So physical address is DS into 10H plus 4000. Okay. So whatever the value present in this location, 8-bit data, you are moving into which register? BL. Okay. Now move AX comma BX. There will be some other previous value present in the BX. That is a 16-bit value. Okay. You are moving into which register? AX. And move DL comma BX. So that means there will be some address which is pointed by BX register. Okay. So DS is nothing but data segment. So the address is calculated with this DS and BX. Physical address is calculated with DS and BX. So whatever this value is there, you are moving into DL register. So whatever the 8-bit data is there, you are moving into DL register. Similarly, move DS comma BX. So you can move the 16-bit data present in the BX register into the data segment. Okay, so you can copy whatever the 16-bit data present in the BX register into DS register. Okay, so these are the examples of the move instruction. Okay, and next push source. So these are nothing but the stack related operations. So whenever any subroutine or a function occurs, okay, any if we want to call a delay function, you have to use this stack. Okay, so you have to push whatever the instruction pointer address, okay, whatever the source into the stack. Okay, so this push source, so you are pushing the whatever the source content. Okay, source can be a memory location or register. Okay, so pushing the source, that is word, into the stack. Okay, so when you are pushing the source into the stack, what happens? It will decrement the stack pointer by 2. Okay, so that means word means how many bytes? 2 bytes. Okay, so whenever you are pushing a word, whenever you are pushing the byte, stack pointer will be decremented by 1. Okay, so that means source must be a word. Okay, so you have to remember source must be a word. So example push CX is there. So CX is a 16-bit register, no? So CX is pushed into the stack. Okay, so what happens here? CH lower. So CL is nothing but the lower byte of CX that will be moved into the stack. Okay. First CH will be moved. Okay, so stack pointer will be decremented. So that means SS is nothing but the address is calculated like this. Stack segment with the stack pointer. Okay, so stack segment SS colon SP minus 1. Okay, so whatever the higher byte of CX, that is CH, whatever the content is there, you are moving into this address location. Similarly, CL lower byte is there. So lower byte you are moving into SS and SP minus 1. So what happens to the stack pointer? Stack pointer will be decremented by 2. Okay. Similarly, push DS is there. So whatever the content of DS is there, you are moving into SS, SP minus 1 and SP minus 2. Stack pointer will be decremented by 2. Okay. Data segment is a 16-bit register. You have to remember. Okay. So whatever the content of data segment register is there, you are moving into stack. Pop destination. So that means pop is nothing but whatever the source you push into the stack, again you are taking from the stack. Okay, so that is nothing but pop operation. Okay, so pop a word from the stack into the given destination, and what happens? It will be incremented the stack pointer by 2. Okay, so while it is taking the word from the stack, what happens? Stack pointer will be incremented by 2. While pushing, stack pointer will be decremented by 2. While popping, stack pointer will be incremented by 2. Okay, so destination can be a register except the CS code segment and the memory location. So destination, so whatever the destination is there, pop destination. So the destination can be a register or memory location. Okay, so see here, so pop CX. So that means whatever the content present in SS and SP and stack segment and SP plus 1, SS and SP you are keeping in CH, and SS and SP plus 1 you are keeping in CL. Okay, so what happens to the stack pointer? Stack pointer will be incremented by 2. Okay, similarly DS, so SS, SP and SP plus 1 you are keeping in DS, stack pointer will be incremented by 2. Okay, so you have to note move, push, pop are only instruction that use segment registers as operands. So that means except CS, so they will use segment registers as operands. Here they used pop, no? So this example pop DS, push DS. Okay, here this move instruction used this segment register, data segment. Okay, except CS, it will not use CS. Okay, similarly pushf is there. Pushf means if you want to move the content of flag register into the stack. Okay, so you are using this instruction. So this is pushf. So this push the value of flag register into the stack, and it decrement the stack. So what is the length of the flag register? It's a 16 bit. Okay, so when you are pushing the content of the flag register into the stack, stack pointer will be decremented by 2. Okay, so pushf example. So whatever the flag register higher byte is there, that we are moving into SS and SP minus 1, and flag register lower byte is there, you are moving into SS and SP minus 2, and similarly stack pointer will be decremented by 2. Similarly popf, so that means whatever the flag register pushed into the stack, again you can take it from the stack and you can keep in the flag register. Okay, so if you see here, pop a word from the stack into the flag register. Okay, so that means popf. So popf means what? SS, SP. So whatever the content present in SS and SP, you are moving into the flag register lower. Okay, so you need to remember. So flag is stack is nothing but last in first out. Okay, so last in so whatever the data you are pushed at the first, it will be taken out. Okay, out first. Okay, so that means here flag register higher byte you pushed first, and flag register lower byte you pushed next. Okay, while popping, what happens? So whatever this flag register higher is there, you are moving into so SS and SP are keeping in flag register lower, and at SS and SP plus 1 you are keeping in flag register higher. So what happens to the stack pointer? Stack pointer will be incremented by 2. Okay, so next, exchange. So what is this exchange? This exchange will exchange the content of two registers. Okay, so this exchange will exchange the source with the destination. Okay, so that means the source can be a register or a memory location. Destination is register, memory location. So here both operands cannot be a memory location. So here example exchange CX comma BX is there. CX is having some value and BX is having some other value. Suppose example CX is having 1 2 3 4 8 and BX is having 5 6 7 8 8. Okay, so exchange CX comma BX means what? CX will get 5 6 7 8 H, okay, hexadecimal number, and BX will get 1 2 3 4 H. Okay, so similarly exchange BL comma CH. So that means you can exchange 2 8-bit numbers. Okay, so example BL consists of 1 2 and CH consists of 2 3. Okay, 1 2 and 3 4. Okay, after exchange BL you will get 3 4 and CH you will get a 1 2. Okay, so this is how you have to do exchange destination comma source. Okay, so next XLAT. Okay, XLAT B and XLAT this is a very important instruction. Okay, this will move into so AL, that means content of memory location in the data segment whose effective address is formed by sum of BX and AL, that will be moved into the AL. Okay, XLAT B. XLAT B means what? You are moving the 8 bit data into the AL register. Okay, whose address is calculated by what? Whose address is calculated by BX, sum of BX register and AL register. Okay, so you see here, you see here example XLAT. Okay, XLAT DS DS colon BX plus AL. Okay, so data segment is having some address. Okay, and how the address is calculated? BX plus AL. Okay, so example DS is having 1000 and BX is having 0200H and AL equal to 03. So as you know, how you calculate the physical address? DS into 10H plus this offset address. Here BX plus EL is acting as an offset. Okay, so DS is 1000, no? 1000 into 10H is how much? 10,000. 10,000 plus 200 plus 3. So what is the effective address or physical address? 1,203. Okay, so that means 10,203. Okay, so whatever the data present in 10,203, you are moving into which register? AL. Okay, understood? So this is XLAC. So that means whatever the data present in the memory location, so that memory location address is calculated by using BX plus AL and DS and BX plus AL. Okay, that physical address. Whatever the content 8-bit data is there, that you are moving into AL. Okay, that is XLAC register. Okay, this is one of the important instruction you need to remember. Okay, LAHF. So LAHF means what? It will load AH with a lower byte of flag register. So we have the flag register, no? So it will load the AH with, so whatever the lower byte of flag register is there, that will be loaded into the AH register. That means AH is nothing but the higher byte of AH. Okay. Similarly, SAHF. SAHF means what? It will source the content of AH into lower byte of the flag register. So whatever the content, lower means what? From the flag register to the AH. Store means from AH to the lower byte of flag register. From AH, from register to the lower byte of flag register. Okay. So here it stores the content of AH into the lower byte of flag register. Okay. It stores the content of AH into the lower byte of flag register. And this LEA register comma store. So that means load effective address. Effective address is also called as offset address. Okay, so loads the effective address of the source into the given register. Okay, so that means load effective address BX comma total is there. So that means there will be effective address, okay, or offset address of total data segment. Okay, so total data segment of the effective address, offset address, it will loads into BX register. Okay, and LDS. LDS is the matter. Load destination register comma source. It loads the destination register and DS register with the offset address and the segment address specified by the source. So that means so whatever the effective address, so whatever the content of DS and total and DS and total plus one, that will be stored into the BX register. Okay. So this is also loads that LES destination comma source, same thing. Okay, so this is IO addressing modes. Okay, IO addressing modes means this will comes under the data transfer instructions. Okay, so as I told you in the last class, that is in and out instructions. Okay, so if we use 8-bit IO address, we get how much range? 00 to FF. Okay, so that means total how many IO ports we can connect. Okay, so 256 IO ports we can connect. Okay, each and every IO port has a specific address. Okay, so this addressing mode will give a port. So that means in. So in means what it will do? EL gets the data from the IO port address 80H. So that means this is the 80H is nothing but one, let us consider the port address of some keyboard. Okay, so whatever the content of that port address is there, okay, whatever the content, whatever the value present in the 80H, you are moving into which register? A. Okay, similarly indirect. So indirect means so first you are moving the address into DX register. So indirectly you are accessing that content by DX register. So first you are, whatever the address is there. So this is used for 16-bit IO address. Okay, 16-bit IO address means what is the address range? 0000 to FFFFH. Okay, so total how many IO ports the microprocessor can access means 65,536 IO ports can access. Okay, if it is 8-bit, total it can access 256 IO ports. So if it is a 16-bit, it can access how many IO ports? So 65,536 IO ports. Okay, so first of all, whatever the IO address is there, that will be stored in the DX register, and So whatever the content of DX, okay, which is pointed by this address, you are moving into AL register. Okay, so AL gets the data from the IO port address 2000 given by DX. Okay, so here this one is fixed. This one is fixed address, fixed port addressing, and this can be variable port address. Okay, so this is in a destination register comma source port. Okay, these are some examples. Okay, similarly out means what? Whatever the content of AL, you are writing into the port address. So it loads the destination IO port with the content of source register. Okay, so here out ATH comma AL is there. So whatever the AL content of AL is there, you are moving into ATH location. So AX, whatever the AX is there, you are moving into ATH. So like this. Okay, so these are not required. Just so this is about the arithmetic instruction. Is it okay? Any doubts in this not arithmetic, data transfer instruction? Is any doubts in this data transfer instruction, students? Please give response so that I can move forward.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, so why I'm telling this instruction sense once again means this will be useful for your lab. Okay, so for the lab you need to do some programs. Okay, so for writing the programs, instruction sense are very much important. That's why I'm revising these concepts. Okay, so arithmetic instruction. So if you see this as some arithmetic instructions, add, sub, multiplication, division. Okay, these comes under the arithmetic instructions. So first of all, we'll see add the destination comma source. So what it will do? It will add the content of source and content of destination, and the result will be stored in where? Destination. Okay, see here, it adds the source to the destination and it stores the result back to the destination. So whatever, what coming to the source, what will be the source? Source can be a register, memory location, or immediate number. Okay, so what is destination? Destination is a register only. You need to remember, destination should be a register. Okay, so and one condition, both the source and destination should be of same size. Okay, so here add C is same as add only, but we are adding along with the carry. Okay, along with the carry flag, you are adding to the source and destination, and the result is stored back to the destination. Okay, so example, add AL comma 25. So there will be some previous value in the AL register. Okay, so whatever the content of AL and 25 you are adding, whatever the result you are getting, you are storing back to the AL. Suppose example AL equal to CM 25. Example 25 is there. 25 plus 25 in hexadecimal, 5 plus 5 is how much? 10. So, but actually in hexadecimal that is A. Okay, 2 plus 2 is how much? 4. 4A. So 4A is the result. 4A will be stored in the AL register. Okay, so similarly, add BL comma CL is there. So that means the content of BL will be added with content of CL, and result will be stored back to the BL register. Okay, similarly, this is a 16-bit addition. So there will be a 16-bit value present in BX register and a 16-bit value present in the CX register. So we are adding the content of BX and CX, and the result will be stored back to the BX register. Similarly, add C. Add C means what? You are adding the BX plus CX along with the carry flag. Okay, suppose carry flag equal to 0, you are adding to the source and destination. Carry flag equal to 1. So before that, you need to use an instruction like a CLC, clear the carry flag, or set C, set the carry flag. Okay, so depending on that carry flag, it will be added to the source and destination, and result will be stored back to the BX register. Okay, so sub and sub destination comma source. So sub, what the sub will do? Just it will subtract the source with the destination, and result will be stored back again to the destination. Okay, so here SUB is nothing but normal subtraction. SBB is nothing but subtraction along with the bar. So here we are using carry flag as a bar. Okay, carry flag as a bar. Okay, you need to remember this. Increment destination. So that means simply it will add one to the specified destination. So destination can be a register or memory location. So carry flag will be not affected. then this carry flag will be not. So in add, add C and sub, sub C, carry flag will be affected. Okay. So that depending on that operation, carry flag may become 1 or 0. So where the carry flag is there, which is there in the flag register, conditional flag. Okay. So increment AX. So you are adding the content of AX with 1. Result will be stored back to the AX. And increment BL. So here you are adding BL with 1. And whatever the result you are getting, suppose. Okay, so 2000. One second. One second.